Affirmative, and we will now continue with that group of amendments.
It's a great pleasure to follow the noble lady Baroness Bakewell after that interruption, and to thank the noble lady for seconding my amendment that clause 42 not stand part of this bill. I find myself seeking new metaphors. We've all been through Henry VIII on steroids. I can't remember which bill it was. I was talking about Henry VIII on steroids with rockets strapped to his boots. I kind of feel like we now have Henry VIII on steroids with rockets strapped to his boots placed in a catapult, because this is an utterly extreme Henry VIII clause. And I fear that noble lords are going to feel like we're going to have a lot of deja vu all over again. In the last group of amendments, the noble lord, Lord Rooker, started us on many of the reflections of the Delegated Powers and Regulatory Reform Committee report. And I think it's worth just looking at paragraph 4 of that. This bill contains 28 delegated powers in just 48 clauses. So it's not really surprising that we're going to be hearing a lot of speeches that sound pretty similar. But I do want to make a particular case for the issue of clause 42, because if you look at the first element of that, regulations may make supplementary, incidental or consequential provision in connection with any provision of or made under this Act. Anything goes. That's essentially — I'm not a lawyer, I've learnt quite a bit about law in the last 3 years. As I understand it, that clause says the minister can do whatever the minister likes. Now, it may be said that, part 3 of clause 42 says this is under the affirmative procedure. Well, I would refer noble lords to what happened yesterday with the voter ID, which demonstrated just how effectively this House is able or not to scrutinise secondary statutory instruments, secondary legislation. We do not have an effective scrutiny power. That is the reality. And so to just say that we can have this bill and then regulations can change anything we like, supplementary, incidental or consequential, then I'm afraid, my lords, there is simply no way that clause 42 should stay part of this bill.